Kyle.
I'm Sam.
I'm Paul.
I'm Allan.
We're Cerebral Bore.
And you're watching Metal Blast.
Fans of bands like Suffocation or like Dying Fetus, fans of these bands would probably
appreciate
it. They'd probably be into it.
Yeah. Sort of like the Suffocation, Dying Fetus, Cannibal Corpse kind of.
But thing. I don't think we're like. I think we're pretty accessible for other types of metal fans as well. You know, not strictly death metal.
Yes.
Or we try to be, anyways.
Basically, me and Paul started the band back in 2006, but we went through several lineup changes between then and say 2010. Then Kyle joined the band on bass, and then we obviously were perfecting the sound, our music. Then obviously we got to writing the album, went down to record it. We had a different vocalist at the time, but then that didn't work out so well. Then Som joined, came in, did vocals, and basically that's how we got Maniacal Miscreation out the way it is now.
Yeah, for me it's been good. I've always been around, you know, just been in the metal world and just been around, like, you know, the guys, so it's not any different for me. But I did have to get used to all the touring and band stuff, because I've never been in a band before, so.
We bet.
That's really good, because like
we
2 years
we
ago.
We bet at Neurotic Deathfest here.
Yeah, that was 2 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, we bet down that corridor.
And I was doing guest vocals for this one-man band called Future Pile, who's
that
here
over
as
there.
Well. And that's how we basically met, because they were on tour with Future Pile. And I did guest vocals for them, and they were watching backstage, and we got in touch via Facebook. And that's how we flew over for audition. I don't know, I've always listened to metal since I was like really young, because my brother used to listen to it, and I just wanted it to get harder and more brutal, so I just started looking up bands and googling, and MySpace and stuff is how I got into
Well, at the end of the day, I look at it like any one of these guys in here right now, and us included, you all start on something lighter and get to the heavier stuff eventually. Yeah. Why should she be any different, you know? It's exactly the same kind of thing.
Yeah, well, we don't know exactly what month or anything, but I mean, it's probably going to be either late summer or towards the end of the year, maybe about November, something like that. But we don't know for sure. We're just taking our time to write good songs, basically. We're not really thinking about the time.
We've just released a new single that's going to be on the album as well.
Yeah, we did a new single. We actually played it live for the first time here.
Last night.
Basically, Paul will write the music. And then what we'll do is I'll sit behind the computer and I'll make the digital drum tracks.
This is what we just started doing. We've only actually done this one time. Everything before that was completely old school, jamming and rehearsing.
Well,
we just recently got a computer and we decided we'll write the shit, and then we'll program it, and then we'll demo it, and then we'll record it.
And then that way he'll do a couple of guitar takes on there, and we'll clean it up, and we'll send that to Som, so she gets to listen to the song before she comes over. And that way, while she's listening to the song and jamming with us with the song, and she gets to practice writing her patterns and lyrics for it and stuff, and then that's how we build the song that way, at the moment, anyway.
I mean, on the last song, like, I wrote some lyrics, Som wrote some lyrics, and we arranged them from the best parts of each part. But I mean, the patterns, all the actual vocal patterns on the last song, the new one that we did, was all Som. So she wrote all the patterns, I wrote a bunch of lyrics, she wrote a bunch of lyrics, and we combined them. On the last album, it was different. Som didn't write anything on the last one. McDibet wrote a couple of songs on the last one. I wrote one song, I did the patterns for another, and we had an old vocalist who wrote two of them. Because we were here at such short notice, like, I figured that a lot of people wouldn't realise that we had been added to the bill. So we went and made a bunch of flyers, and we spent all afternoon yesterday walking around, handing out flyers to say we're playing tonight, putting posters up, and so I think that made a difference, because tons of people that we gave the flyers to had no idea that we had even been added. But I met maybe three or four people yesterday who were like, are you not supposed to be in the States with Hate Eternal? So most people didn't realise we were here. For us to go and do the tour, we had to obtain visas at the American Embassy. And we went and did the visa application and the meeting and all that stuff. And then basically three out of the four visas came back, and one of them didn't come back. And that one actually only came the same day that we left to come to Neurotic. That final visa came that day. But we had already announced that we won't make it out for the tour by that point. I mean, there were like four, maybe five shows left out of like 20 something, so yeah, it was a bit of a shame. But hopefully we're going to be back in America like really soon, so it should be alright. It's a bit of a shame, but I mean, now we have the visas, so next time it's just book flights and we're there.
Let's go.
Well, the first time we went, 2007, no one knew who we were at all. We only just started up like a year before. Then we went again in 2008, and we went for 6 weeks, and even then nobody really knew who we were. Maybe a little tiny bit of world in the underground. Then when we went back last year, a lot of people knew who we were. We had a lot of people out at the shows with t-shirts, and like, it was good. We definitely felt a big difference. But I mean, even the amount of promotion that has been going on between us and between our label, and we've got an American booking agent now. So since then we've had a lot more promotion going on, so I expect the next time we go back it'll be even better. If we could be in a studio all day and writing songs all day and that's all we did, it would be phenomenal. Hopefully one day we will be at that stage, you know what I mean? I'm sure that like Cannibal Corpse don't need to go out and work a full-time job to make ends meet, you know? So, I mean, if they can get to that stage, maybe we can in 10 years, you know? So, we haven't had these illusions for a very long time, you know? It was mostly in the beginning. You have these illusions about, like making your money from death metal and all this. And that's what all the fans seem to think still, that there's a lot of money being made behind the scenes. But, yeah, most of them understand. You know, all you have to do is basically tell them the expenses that you usually have to go through and what things cost, and then they understand, okay, there's not as much money in it as I expected, you know. We only ever wanted to become better at playing, faster at playing, more endurance. So yeah, it was always just about being brutal. It still is, you know. I mean, all we care about really is like being brutal, being catchy, being groovy and having good songs. Everything else is a bonus.
So in about 1 week we've got tours, suffocation, cattle decapitation,
and blood red throne.
Blood red throne. And paint pullouts.
Yeah, see, just on that one.
We're doing that's a UK tour for like 4 to 5 days?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Then we do a Hammerfest in Wales with Anthrax and a couple other big bands, Paradise Lost, Skindred, and then we have a show in Paris in April. Then we do SWR Festival in Portugal in April, and then We have an Eastern European tour in September, but as far as I'm aware, it's going to be Bulgaria, Romania, Serbia, Greece, Slovenia,
Hungary.
That might be it. Something like that. Is there more? Nah, not Czech Republic. Probably Eastern. Nah, that's about it, I think. But,
it's really, really, really difficult, but the thing that helps is the agreement I have with my job. My manager's actually really, really supportive of the band. Anytime we're in magazines and stuff, I'll show him, and he wants to see the thing, and he'll read the reviews, and he'll look at interviews, and he goes online and looks at videos and says, "Oh, I saw your new video, and it's awesome." He really enjoys what we do and stuff, so he actually gives me the time off I need to go and do it, no matter what. Even if I was to walk in and say, "Look, I've been offered a last minute tour in the States, and I need to fly out a week tomorrow," he'd be like, "Right, okay." He won't be over the moon about it, but he'll still let me go, and he'll still let me come back to a full time job. But juggling the full time job with the full time band, you know, it does get pretty hectic at times.
Well, I can't do it at all, you know what I mean? Like, I do management for the band, and like, I do all that stuff. And if I had to have any kind of full time job, like, all the business side of Cerebral Bore would go fucking down.
I think it's bar work, man.
It takes all the time you've got.
So basically, he's doing the managing, and most of the time the tour organisations, the show organisations and stuff. So if you were basically get a job, then yeah. I think your bed will go.
We suggest if you're going to go for a job, get a bar work.
The new song that we just recorded.
It's called Horrendous Excellence.
Yeah.
Go and check it out.
So we're going to be doing a music video for that song. We actually had a music video booked in order to do in Hollywood last week, but we never made it on the tour, so the shoot fell through. So we're going to be filming a new video for that in the next week or two. It's going to be with a different director, so I mean, a lot of it's going to be down to their sort of vision, you know.
Style.
I mean, in Hollywood, we were only going to do a kind of like a live performance video, like the video for the Bald Cadaver, but that was because we were really restricted on time, and we only had like 5 or 6 hours to do the shoot. But now that we're going to be doing it in England, it may be like totally different, I'm not sure.
If you want to check our new single out, it's on YouTube.
Yeah, it's on iTunes.
Metal Blast!